Wow. Twice? I just opened a pack with no playables. Like, I get that I'm black and green, but am I supposed to open packs that have all white, red, and blue cards in them? Always? I'll say I've certainly run below average in that respect so far this draft, but I do like my deck so far. And I think I'll just take the commune. Just to stay on point and, you know, try and draft the best deck I could possibly draft. Could take a Sea God's Revenge to try to splash it, but I'm not particularly aggressive. I have no fixing. It's another spell in my deck that I'm trying to play a lot of creatures in. So I think I'm going to ignore that for now. And I think I'm just going to go with the commune. And just hope that my graveyard strategy works out. Here I'm going to take Disciple of Fennax. It's great. Works with all my cards. Can never ever beat Fabled Hero in a million years, but let's not concern ourselves with such things when there's nothing we can do about it. Ah, Frieza's Mender. It's very nice to have. I would love Sedge Scorpion. Otherwise, I mean Mender is just the point of trying to draft this deck is to get a Mender, so I will take it. I think I'll take a Burnished Heart. Curse of the Swine and Wingsteed Rider are both awesome magic cards, but Burnished Heart's like not even that great, but it seems better to me than just counter drafting. I have no interest in a Vulping Goliath. Yeah, I'll just take Burnished Heart. I will play with it unless something changes. Good lord. This is a lot of Wingsteed Riders that I can't particularly beat. I guess I'll take it this time. I mean, I'm not going to take one of these other cards. Just none of these cards can even go in my deck. That's the unfortunate thing. Maybe the Colossus of Akros, but I'll just take a Wingsteed Rider. This pack has not gone well. Passed roughly 10 Wingsteed Riders. Polis Crusher or Blood Toll Harpy. Crusher is actually a really, really good card. Might be worth splashing if I take it here. I mean, I would be happy to play with Blood Toll Harpy. It is more redundancy in a deck that is trying to have a lot of redundancy. So I do want that Shredding Winds, too. I think having multiple of those will help me beat all the Wingsteed Riders rolling around the table. Is there any way I can fix my mana to make this Polish Crusher work? Probably not. I would just have to play 18 lands and play some mountains. I'll just take the Blood Toll Harpy and hope that my strategy is good. Doesn't seem like it will be just yet, but I mean, Burnished Heart is a very inconvenient way of fixing your mana for a card like Polish Crusher, because you have to go turn 3, Burnished Heart. Turn 4, sacrifice it. Turn 5, here's a 4-4, when it's not at all different than a Vulping Goliath at that point. The value in Polish Crusher is casting it on turn 4. So Blood Toll Harpy at least makes me feel better about playing communes and not bricking. Boy, this is a bad pack. Would I ever play a Ferris Band Centaur? Maybe. Not gonna play Fellhide Minotaur, I'll tell you that right now. Scourge Mark is also not what I'm looking for. Glare of Heresy is a good answer to Wingsteed Riders, but I'm not going to play white in my deck, so here's a 3-7. I could see myself playing with the loathsome Cataplebus. Thing is, it's hard to splash a card like Polish Crusher with the cards I have, because I have, like, this card requires black and green. This is double black. This requires green on exactly turn 2. So, goodness gracious, another Wingsteed Rider. I could have had like 5. Ugh. I think I'm just going to take Cavern Lampad. Yep, because that's a card I'm actually going to put in my deck. I wish I had known to draft white, but the problem is, like, I had a strong signal to play both green and black in the early portions of the draft. Also, like, purely by coincidence, my opening packs had no good green or black cards once I had made the decision to play green and black. Like, I had Whip of Erebos. Maybe it's possible I could have had a black-white heroic deck, but I figured that out far too late in the draft. And hindsight is 20/20, so... I like my deck, actually. So, we'll see how it works out for me. Let's take Stoneshock Giant, because it's particularly hard for me to beat. Yep, just take a commune here. It is unlikely that I'll want to play with four of them, but I could. It would make my deck as streamlined and as focused as possible if, like, I mean, I will say this. I've only drafted a deck like this once before. I had an okay record, not great, but if it's actually a good, smart thing to draft this deck, it's great to learn how. And I have all of the hallmark cards that you could want, except for Grey Merchant. Like, if I had one or two Grey Merchants, this deck would be, like, amazing instead of just probably pretty good. But also, I think it's quite valuable to learn whether or not this is a deck that you want to draft. Like, here I'm going to take... I'm 0% to want 5 Commune with the Gods, so it's Centaur or Hunt the Hunter. I think I'm going to go with Centaur. Yep, I have like 4 green creatures, so it's hard to justify Hunt the Hunter. Anyways, let's say this deck is great. Like, Dredge is one of the best decks that you can get at the next premier level draft that I play in, like at a Grand Prix Day 2 or something. If I open Whip and I take it, and then my options are Nemesis of Mortals or Griptide, should I take Griptide and draft blue-black, or should I take the Mortals and draft the Dredge deck that I know is unbeatable when you get the pieces that you need? So, surely people will say in the comments, oh my god, all the Wingsteed Riders, you could have had unbeatable heroic. But I know how to draft heroic. If I was drafting solely for the purposes of winning, then heroic is a fine thing to do, but I think learning whether or not the Dredge deck has some value too. Take Wild Celebrants because it can destroy my Whip. Boy, I got a lot of yoked ox today. It is clear that nobody in the draft wanted the cards Return Centaur, Commune with the Gods, or Blood Toll Harpy, and many of them were opened, and they all ended up in my pile, so... Building this deck might be a little tricky because I know that I have to keep a really high creature count. I think I'll probably choose not to play with Rescue from the Underworld because I have other very good incentives for Graveyard. I would have been great to get a Night Howler. Let's see what we got here. 24 with 16 creatures. That's pretty good, actually. I'll cut one card and then maybe a creature. I think this Burnished Heart is like pretty bad for me. But also, I don't want to play with Fellhide Minotaur. Seems like a weak card when you have I have three returned centaurs and no real reason to want devotion. Or like a 2-3 just average creature. So maybe Burnished Heart is better. Or the 3-7, but I don't think so. Could just take Burnished Heart. Deck looks pretty nice, actually. Could play 18 lands. I have Voyaging Satyr, though, and I don't want to mill lands. Like, it sounds silly to say, but when I mill a land, nothing good happens for me. At least when I mill a creature. Also, don't really want a mana flood. I think I'll run it like this. Could see Anvil Rot Raptor in the deck, but no, let's not bother. I think I'm gonna go, yeah, let's go 9-8. Yep. Woo!